What's up? How we all doing tonight? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You guys got a lot of energy. I did a show last night and nobody laughed. Man, no, aw. I called my manager. I said, hey, don't be booking me at the cemetery anymore. I ain't getting no feedback. And like, you know, funerals, they're not fun, so I don't understand why the first three letters in funeral are fun. It doesn't work. Y'all give it up for Richard Villa for inviting me out here. After the show, we're gonna go in the jacuzzi in his armpits. Man. Woo! Nah. Hey, check this out. I know I wore red tonight, and like gangsters, they're dogging me all night, so I'm gonna clear it up right now. I'm not North Daniel, I'm not Sue Daniel, I'm Jalapeno. My favorite color is green. If I was in a gang, it'd be gangrene. The gangster that was up here earlier, we were in the back. He asked me what I claimed. It's a good thing I had my tax forms on him. I said exempt. What, fo? I punked him, right? Said, what block you from? He said H&R. I looked it up on MapQuest. It doesn't exist. So I don't know. And I don't understand the concept of getting jumped into a gang. You gotta get beat by five other guys. And I said, wait, it happens to the Lakers every night. Hey, you guys booing me or the Lakers? Yeah. All right. We'll get the eraser on that one. Nah, you know what? I know this chola, and her gang name was Gum. Well, I didn't understand at first either, so I asked her, why do they call you Gum? She said, I have no ass, so I'm cheekless. And she was cool, you know? She had a tattoo of a butterfly on her back. But she was like a big chick. So it looked like an eagle. I thought it was a Mexican flag. I put my hand on my chest. It had the worm and everything. Well, I took a closer look. It was a stretch mark. She was big. Apparently, when a gangster kills somebody, they get a teardrop right here. Because they're sad, right? About killing somebody. But she was big, so it looked like a Hershey kiss. I took a bite out of it, had an almond. Okay, it was a pimple. But, you know, I gave her a shot. I got to know her. She said her whole life she thought she had leukemia. So I asked her, well, why do you think you had leukemia? And, like, you know, they picked on her at school. So she asked her mom, hey, mom, why did the kids pick on me? And her mom said, Luki, mija. I don't know. And I'm not saying all gangster chicks are dumb, but she was. She thought that Walmart was clumsy because they were always dropping their prices. Oh, I was at her house, and I just bought a new CD. I wanted to burn it. She had a CD burner, so I asked her, is it okay if I burn my CD? She said, go ahead. I don't have any matches, though. She thought The Wizard of Oz was a drug movie, The Wizard of Ounce. Man, I'm here for peace. He's here for a piece of ass. Who said that? I can't even see over there. Who else is gonna boo me? Nobody else, right? Just that guy? All right, okay, cool. Nah, but you guys been drinking all night. Be careful. You don't wake up tomorrow like Michael Jackson's baby hungover. Hey, my name is Cesar Serrato. Thank you very much. Man, I got scared when I got here. There was like a group of gangsters outside. And like, they started hitting me up, right? I guess what they ask you, right? They ask you what you claim. And luckily I have my tax forms on me. Good man, exempt, fool. Damn. I added all the lines and everything. Gangsters are dangerous. There's a whole posse of them, right? There's this big chola too. And you know, I have light eyes, so she asked me if I had contacts. I told her, I know a lot of people. And she wanted to know where I was from. She asked me what block I'm from. I told her H&R. Come find me, I'm all over. I don't even understand the concept of getting jumped into a gang. You gotta get beat by 9 other guys. And I said, wait, it happens to the Dodgers all the time. By Dodger fans, but I guess not. Nah, you know what? Where in my neighborhood, where I grew up, it was a gang neighborhood, and there's your Bloods and your Crips and your Norteños and your Sureños. And I didn't want to take the gang life, so I kept it neutral. I was jalapeno. All my homies together, we all like the color green, so that was the name of our gang, Gang Green. Don't mess with us. We're tough, man. Come to your hood and spray paint in green. Yeah. And you know what? My neighbor, she's a chola, right? She had a tattoo of a butterfly right here, but she was big, so it looked like an eagle. One day I was walking behind her, and you know, it looked like the eagle was flying. It had a snake in the mouth and everything, right? I thought it was the Mexican flag. I put my hand on my chest. Well, I took a closer look. It wasn't a snake, it was a stretch mark. Yeah, yeah. I looked real close. Apparently, when a gangster kills somebody, they get a teardrop of a tattoo right here. That's the leader of a gang over there. Well, you know what? My neighbor, she had big cheeks like this. So, you know, it didn't look like a teardrop. It looked like a Hershey kiss. But without the wrapping, started kissing it. It had almonds. All right, it was a pimple. I got her Noxzema pads for Christmas. And you know what? Gangsters, they like the little pit bulls, you know, the dangerous dogs. And she had one, right? And the dog's name was Syndrome. You know, he was a cool dog, he was nice. But when I would walk to school, you know, he got excited, so he jumped all over me one day. So I had to tell him, hey, get down, Syndrome! Get down, Syndrome! The other neighbor got all mad.
I already have it.
Yeah? All right. Yes. Anyone else? Got it. Ah, you know what? He was a blood. And he always tried to pressure little kids into getting jumped into the gang. So that's what the kids around the neighborhood knew him as. You know, we called them blood pressure. So I would be going to school, right? And I'd see him. So I'd say, hi, blood pressure. He was a cool guy, though. Hey, you know what, guys? My comedy career is going good. I just auditioned for the new TV show, Mexican Idol. I sang a tight song too. I sang it real good. Have you guys heard of the Iguana song? Okay, can I sing a little of it real quick? All right, all right. Oh yeah. I'm gonna wish you a Merry Christmas. Yeah. I didn't get the part. I didn't like that one. Hey, earlier today I went to Subway because I was hungry, right? And that's what people do when they're hungry, they go to Subway. I try to pay with the $50 bill, and you know, the register lady, she's like, well, we don't accept anything larger than a 20. So I pull out a 20 and I put it next to my 50, and they're the same size. So you gotta take that sign down. You're confusing people. What kind of money do I pay with here? And when I was in line, you know, there was a guy behind me. I guess I was in his way because he said, hey, you're in my way. So I turned around and I said, okay, this is the only time I'm gonna urine your way. I peed all over him. Sucker. Woo! Be careful for what you ask for. Yeah? All right. I'm glad we all go to Subway and pee on people. You know what, guys? You guys have fun. You guys drink the rest of the night, but be careful. You guys don't drink too much, because tomorrow you might wake up like Michael Jackson's baby, hungover. Into a gangster outside. Oh yes, I was scared. He started asking me questions. He's like, yo dog, what block you from? I told him H&R. Come find me, I'm all over.
I got people. Gangsters interrogate you. He's like, nah, dog, what you claim? Luckily, I had my tax forms on me. Said, look, fool, exempt. I confused them. Look, homie, what set you from? I haven't done any movies. I don't even understand the concept of getting jumped into a gang. You gotta take a beating from 11 guys. And I said, wait a minute, it happened to the Raiders all last season. So if they could take it, anyone can. I knew this gangster chick, her gang name was Gum. I asked her, why they call you Gum? She said, cause I have no ass, so I'm cheekless. And she was big, right? She had a tattoo of a butterfly right here, but she was big, so it looked like an eagle. I thought it was the Mexican flag. I put my hand on my chest. Cause it had the snake and everything, right? Well, I took a closer look, it was a stretch mark. It was a big stretch mark. Apparently, when a gangster kills somebody, they get a tattoo of a teardrop right here. But she had big cheeks, so it looked like a Hershey kiss. I started kissing on it. It had almonds. Okay, it was a pimple. I know. I keep it neutral. I'm not Norteño and I'm not Sureño. I'm jalapeno. My favorite color is green. If I was in a gang, it'd be gangrene. And they say what doesn't kill you only makes you stronger. I have a friend, he died lifting weights. And funerals, they're not fun, so I don't understand why the first three letters in funeral spell fun. Right. I did a show last night and nobody laughed. They all just had their arms crossed and their eyes closed. So I called my manager, I was like, hey, dog. You can't be booking me at the cemetery anymore. I didn't get no feedback. You guys drink a lot tonight, okay? Like a lot. But tomorrow you might wake up like Michael Jackson's baby hungover. They're gonna sound like the guy on The Simpsons. Can I get another beer? All right, some of us watch The Simpsons. That's Barney, yes. All right, you watch too much Simpsons. I seen this Marine guy, he was taking a So I called it a military discharge. Okay. And you know what, gangsters, they give them little, the dogs, the dangerous dogs, the little boxers and the pit bulls. Yes. This is the gangster side over there. All right. My neighbor had one of those, right? And the dog's name was Syndrome. It was a real cool dog, real nice and friendly. One day he jumped all over me, so I told him, get down, Syndrome. Get down, Syndrome. My other neighbor got all mad. I really have to. Hey, this side got punked by this side earlier. They were a little bit louder. I went to Subway today, guys, and I tried to pay with a $50 bill, but the lady at the register, she's like, yo, we don't accept anything larger than a 20. So I pulled out a 20 and I put it next to my 50 and they were the same size. I was like, what kind of money do you pay with here? Take that sign down, it's confusing. And there was a guy behind me. He's like, hey, you're in my way. So I turned around, I said, okay, this is the only time I'm gonna urine your way. I peed all over him. He was pissed. Hey guys, my comedy career is going good. I saved up all my comedy money and 2 days ago I finally got my own clothing line because I don't have a dryer. It's real cool, it came with clothespins. It was on sale, so I said, what's up? Yes. All right. Hey, you know what? This big girl, right? They say TV adds 10 pounds. She must have been on TV a lot. But I'm gangster too, right? I'll get down with the big chick. And you punk guys, why you guys wanna turn the lights off because they're big? That's jacked up, right? I'll keep the lights on. Because in my top drawer, I have a blindfold. I can see everything. One time this big chick, she took something I said the wrong way. She had a flat tire and I wanted to help her, right? So I was like, hey, do you have a spare tire? Are you saying I'm fat? No, why have love handles when you can have love seats? All right. Let's see. I called this house. Ready? I called the company, right, to try to solve a problem I had. And their motto was, if we can't do it, no one can. I said, I know, you're the last one I called. Hey, my name is Cesar Serrato. Thank you very much.